Hey all, welcome or welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing few tips and tricks on how to stop impulsive buying. This is the time so many offers are launched and everything, and so many products are launched. Festive season, right? You get so many things on flash sale, offer is going on, and this is actually the time we start buying things that we actually want and not need. And many of us are also going and buying things we actually don't even need and want, but we end up buying just because of the fact that it's in offer sale. So that's why I'm making this video. It's going to be a short video, but an important one. So I kindly request you all to watch the video till the end. Let's begin with the video. People love products, they want love offers and everything. When the festive times are around, especially Christmas and New Year, we tend to gift something to our friends, family, or we even tend to gift something to ourselves. Not gifting, but we tend to go ahead and buy. We tend to add a lot of things in our Amazon cart, Flipkart cart, whatever e-commerce stores are there out there. We tend to go and shop everywhere, and oftentimes after purchasing them, we realize we actually didn't need them. Then why the hell did I invested in this product, right? And this is also the golden hour for the marketers, for the service providers, for coaches, basically people like me, to come and sell their products and offers. And hell yeah, I'm also going to launch certain products and offers and whatnot. But as much as it is true that I market my services, that I'm an entrepreneur, that I have to sell my things and offers, it is also equally true that I'm also a consumer just like you. So I follow certain rules and certain tips which help me to stop from impulsive buying that I might go buy and waste my money. And that is exactly what I'm going to share with you. How exactly can we stop this impulsive buying, in the hopes that this video can also be helpful for you. So please watch the video till the end. The very first tip that I have for you is, before you go ahead and buy anything, even the smallest of thing, even groceries, at times we go to supermarket and we see certain things which are packed in a beautiful way, in beautiful boxes, shiny plastic cars and everything, and we get excited. Pause, just pause immediately there and ask yourself if this is really a need to you or if this is a want. Can you survive without it? Or you need it to survive, like basic things like food, electronics, anything like that. Or example, if your charger is dead or if your phone is not working, then going ahead and investing in one phone will make a lot of sense, because then the phone will become a need and not a want. But if a new iPhone is launching in the market and you just have bought another iPhone, right? A new iPhone and a brand new version is getting launched, and if you can afford it, by all means you can go ahead and buy it. You will not even be seeing this video if you can afford it, right? You're seeing this video because you have your reasons, and that becomes actually a want and not a need. I would say an expensive want, not even a want, right? So you don't need that iPhone. When something is launched in the market, you don't have to immediately, oh my God, that's launched, I have to go and get it. When you're going to a supermarket, rather than getting the important necessary groceries that you actually need, instead of going and getting something that you may want. Even for snacks, you can actually set limits. I will teach you all that in the next videos, but are we actually setting that limit? Self-analysis and become self-aware will help you in deciding this factor. So before you add anything to your cart, before you go to shopping and add anything in your shopping bag, just ask yourself, look at the product and ask if this is a want or a need. If it is a need, put back in the shopping cart and go ahead and buy it. If it is a want, you can get it any other time, not right now. Keep it in the shelf and move on. Coming to the second tip, now the want and need actually comes with mostly affordable ranges product. But if you have been eyeing on an expensive item, let's say a new iPad is launched, or a budget friendly iPad with all the features have been cut down, and I think a new iPad is also getting launched, which can be used by students, for students specifically. So that's an expensive product, right? Now, if you want to go ahead and buy it, add it to your cart and wait. Wait for at that particular time when something is getting launched, when you go to your Amazon, when you swipe anything, not only Amazon, but any e-commerce store, you immediately go and swipe it. Oh my God, that's so good. That's so cool. I have this offer. It's discounted. It's in 2,000 rupees off, 1,000 rupees off. Yeah, I can understand. I have also been there. So I'm not asking you not to buy it. If it is an expensive, you will make an informed decision. But just add it in your cart and wait for at least a few hours. Don't look at your cart. Just concentrate on your other work, or even a day, much better, or 2 days, and then get back and think: do you really want it? I mean, is it actually your need, or can you wait for some time? This will give you some clarity on making the decision. Even after 2-3 days, if you think, no, I need this, I mean, this is important to me, by all means, go ahead and buy it. But if you understand, and if you have this problem of impulse buying, then you have to wait at least for a day and then go back to your cart. You will get more clarity and you will make an informed decision. In the first two tips, we were talking in depth about the products, like how should you decide and how should you wait before you go ahead and buy anything. But recently I have also been getting a lot of requests from most of you in my Instagram DM asking, Abhi, I'm totally confused when I have to go ahead and get a new course. And all the studious people out there who are watching this video, I can completely understand. I'm one such nerd that I will be okay with any cosmetic products, or even if any stationery products, I can wait for them actually. Trust me, it will be hard for you to trust with all the stationeries that I have. But anytime a course is getting launched, especially in Udemy, I just can't, like, you know, control the impulse. I immediately want to go ahead and get it. Usually around the times when Udemy, Christmas and New Year time, they give some offer. Coursera, they give some offer. So all these online e-learning platforms, when they launch some offer, and especially when our favorite coaches or any new coaches are launching anything, it becomes slightly overwhelming for us to realize and understand which course is going to be the best fit for us. And especially when you go search for one thing, your Google friend will automatically start dumping your mobile, your devices with similar ads. You will see a lot of such courses and your confusion rate is just going to increase and increase. But don't worry, I'm here to help you with that also. So especially when you're going to select any particular course or service, please go ahead. They will have a complete landing or sales page. You don't need to know what a landing or sales page is, but what you have to know is there will be an information, there will be a complete website or a page talking in detail about the product they are selling. In this case, the course. What are the modules of the course? What is the curriculum of the course? Is this course for beginners or for intermediate level or for advanced level, where you are right now? Are you going to get any personal help or at least group life supports? Or is this the self-study course? And how many hours or days or months you're going to get access to this particular course? How exactly can you apply this course while you're learning? So all these things combined will help you make an informed decision. And I would say, instead of going by the rates that the person is offering you, any coach is offering you, I will highly recommend you guys to take a minute, go to their pages and do a complete research. And also, many of them would have added their reviews, their previous students' reviews, testimonials and all such things. Go ahead, spend time. That person has reviewed this course because they have taken it and they have loved it, right? So go ahead and read that review. From that review, you will be able to analyze if this is the right fit for you, or should you go for another level course and not the beginner level course. Just by spending 5 to 10 minutes of your time, you will be able to avoid this impulse buying and make an informed decision. And I made this video in the hopes that it will help you make an informed decision, especially after making the planner video. And this time you're going to get bombarded with so many ads, not only with courses, free masterclasses, webinars and everything. Even before registering for a free masterclass, ask yourself if this is really important for you, or will you get a recording? If they are launching their masterclass on Saturday at a particular time, Sunday on a particular time, will you be available? Can you go ahead and learn it? Or are you just buying because it's free? What's happening? I also see a lot of masterclasses for 99 rupees, 199, 299. At the moment when we see it's not a lot of money, so we go ahead and invest it. And I have seen a lot of people who don't even know that these masterclasses don't have a replay, or their expiry date will be 2 to 3 days. After that, you will not get access to it. So most of the people will not attend the classes on Saturday and Sunday. They will expect, they are fine, I will attend it on the coming weekend. That will not happen. Their money is gone. So take your time in understanding if this is the right fit for you or not. If they have any customer support provider, please spend your time, talk to them, and then make an informed decision. I really hope these small reminders will really help you in making an informed decision. Just take your time in applying these techniques and let me know if they will help you. And trust me, they really will be, because I have used them and I apply them every time I go ahead and make any kind of purchase. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and that you got some useful tips. Trust me, if you spend some time in applying these techniques, they would really help you, because they have personally helped me in a lot of ways whenever I have to go and purchase anything. And with that being said, if you like any particular point or if you're going to try any one technique that I have taught in this video, please go ahead and comment and let me know. I mean, this is what I'm going to do, and I would really love to read all your comments. And go give thumbs up to my video. Subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed yet, and please hit that bell notification so that you will get notified whenever I upload my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.